What's up, everybody? It's Jang here with some more Lego minifigures from series 14 to open up. I'm going to go through another 20 of them in this video. I already did 20, so we'll get past the halfway mark and get to the finishing stretch. Let's just go ahead and get right into it with the openings, and we'll see what kind of distribution we get of packs this time. And I think I know now to take out the instruction sheet first and then dump out the parts. So the Brown Yeti, as I like to call him, is the first one. Once again, if you want to guess what the last one is, feel free, post up the comment about that. Give you a little more time, a little more advance warning about it this time. And once again, I'm going from front to back. And this is the middle column. Ooh, another one of those already. The middle column of the box. Seems like they did randomize these quite much better than before. I don't remember which series. I think there were two different series that I got a full box of in recent memory. And with both of those, I found clusters, definite clusters. Well, I mean, one of them was just all of one type of figure was in one area. All of the next type was in the next area. It just kind of went on like that. But this one is randomized as it needs to be. Although, I personally, I think I should just continue with what I was doing before with the columns of four. I personally think that the days of the blind bag are numbered. I feel like they kind of need to start coming up with something different, something better. Because, I don't know, the whole Mr. Gold thing that was supposed to be completely randomized, but it was kind of a nightmare with what it ended up doing. But even with these packs, you know, they're always the more desirable ones. And I guess they just can't know which ones are going to be the most desirable. Obviously with Mr. Gold, you know, that was very obvious. But with things like this, they can't know without kind of spilling the beans way in advance and letting all the terrible clone copycat, you know, completely illegal companies out there make copies before Lego even comes to market. So they can't kind of give a preview to folks to ask, hey, which of these do you like the most? You know, do a survey or something like that. If they do, then all the other clone companies will make the exact same thing in advance. But something, I feel like something needs to be done to kind of move us past this world of the blind bag, and to move us past the world of six adults standing around creating kind of a cove, a wall of bodies standing in front of the box of minifigs at the Lego store for, you know, basically all day, just continuously having that wall of them just sitting there going derp, derp, derp. You know, it's just, there's something very wrong about that. And I wish that they could just, these guys, Lego, anybody who makes these, could just go ahead and put a little window in the package. Make even numbers of all of them, or, you know, do a little better research internally inside of the company with folks who know Lego stuff well. Find some real trusted fans and put some really, really strict NDAs on them and get some feedback in advance and find out what people want, and then, you know, adjust the quantities of each figure accordingly, make the most of the things that people want the most, and then let people see what they're going to get before they get it. Why not? I think that would be a better system, personally. The whole reason that they do these, well, there are two reasons that they do these like this, as far as I understand, that they don't let you see what you're going to get in advance. First of all, it sells more when people don't know what they're going to get, and Most folks don't sit around for an hour. You know, it just drives those casual sales of, oh, maybe I'll get something good. The other thing is just the whole idea of a surprise. You know, there's something about that. There's something that's fun about not knowing what you're gonna get. But I think it's mostly the sales, the extra sales that they'll get from folks who just want a couple figures in particular, and especially if those end up being more rare, then more people will buy more packs. But still, if they made it so you could see what you were gonna get, they could charge a little bit more, because people who know that they're not gonna have to go through a bunch of packs would be willing to pay just a little extra for that certainty. I think that's just my thought. That's what I think about it. I just feel like this whole idea is starting to run its course. It's nothing new. Lego didn't invent this idea. A lot of folks I know kind of feel like this is the Lego thing, and then anybody else or any other company that makes blind bags is copying Lego. But I mean, the first random pack thing that I bought myself was something from a, you know, one of those candy dispenser kind of machines at the front of a supermarket back in, would have been the late 80s. It was 25 cents. And that was a long time before Lego Series 1 collectible minifigures came out. And I know that those types of things have been around for a lot longer than that. So it's a lottery, basically. It's a way that kids can play the lottery. But I would like it to change. I would like it to get advanced. We're in this world of all these smartphones and all this high technology and stuff, and a lot of folks, you know, have levels of awareness that we didn't have decades ago. There has to be a better way to do this. Anybody have any ideas? Or is this just it? Is this kind of the limit of what you can do with these, and anything beyond that has to move into full-on figure packs and things? You know, if you're gonna show all of them, if you're gonna show what you're gonna be able to get, then put them into, you know, just a completely different form factor and not individual figures. So there we go. Now you see what all has come out of this. Again, a pretty good random distribution. Only one of the Banshee there and one of the Spectre, but let me go ahead and build these up so you can see them all complete. So there we go. And I tried to kind of group them together roughly the same as I did with the previous video, although I don't have the exact same figures this time. And yes, there are two Banshees. I forgot about the one that I opened earlier on, but this is what the distribution looks like for this set of 20. So once again, pretty well randomized, although I do notice that it's pretty conspicuous that the first 20 got 3 of the Tiger Lady, and this one got none of those. Also, the first 20 got none of the Zombie Businessman, and this one got 2 of those. Other than that, oh yeah, this one got the 2 witches. I guess 2s are out of 60. Groups of 2s are no big deal. I guess the Tiger Lady is the one that kind of stands out, having gotten 3 of those with the first 20 and none in this grouping here. But they weren't all together. You know, they were not grouped together like back to back or anything. They just happened to be in the same row. And that can happen, you know, statistically. You know, it's not that big of a deal. So I really do feel like they did randomize these quite well with their positions in the box, but I still have 20 more to open up before we can find out exactly, or before I can find out for certain exactly what the total distribution is in this box. Plenty of folks have opened these boxes before, and I'm sure there are plenty of numbers out there, but I'll be able to verify that now and just, you know, experience it myself with the actual opening and share that with all of you, you know, the whole surprise element of it. So that's it for this video. One more of these to go, and then I'll be able to do a summary as well. Thank you for watching, and I'll be talking to you again very soon.